Good morning, student. Welcome to the fourth lecture of unit number 3. In the last lecture, we had discussed about what is hardwired control unit and micro program control unit. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to discuss about micro instructions and micro program sequencing. Okay, so now we know that program is a set of instructions and instruction is a set of micro instruction. So to perform micro instruction, micro operations on that micro instructions, we need to generate control signals in a proper sequence. So now who is responsible for generating control signals? Control unit. Okay, control unit is responsible for generating control signal. Okay, so with these all terms we had discussed in the previous lecture. Now let's start with the micro operations first. So it is the first goal or step to build the control unit. So to build a control unit, you need to understand what does the control unit basically do. A control unit generates control signal. Now what does this control signals do? They cause small activities inside the processor, and those small activities are called as micro operations. So when you understand what are the micro operations, then only you can understand why we need control signals. Okay, so program is a set of instruction. An instruction requires a set of small activities performed by the processor called as micro operations. So to perform micro operations, we need control signal. And those control signals are produced by the control unit. Okay, so this is the processor. These are the main components of the processor. So this is a processor connected to external memory and IO devices. And with the help of system bus, you know, system bus has three parts, that is address bus, data bus, and control bus. Okay, now whichever the instruction you do, whether addition, subtraction, or whatever, first of all, instruction has to be fetched into the processor. Okay, so now, first of all, we independently learn what are the micro operations required for fetching. There are two ways. Some processor do like, now look here. First, we learn different ways in which instructions can be fetched. Hence, I am using, for example, register addressing mode. Okay, so this is the processor. This is the processor. This is a memory. In a memory, there are thousands of memory locations. These are the memory locations. And in a memory, for example, there are thousands of memory locations. Program is stored in a series of locations. So these are the address for instruction. Now let's consider. This is the first address for first address of first instruction, and so on. To fetch any instruction from the memory, the processor will processor has to be given an address. The processor will put the address on the address bus. And by using MAR, that is memory address register, the instruction is selected. It will now come the processor through the data bus. Okay, now by using address bus, processor fetch the instruction from particular memory location, and after fetching instruction is come into the processor by using processor data bus. Okay, so instruction come through which bus? By data bus. So data also come from which bus? Data bus. Okay, so in the memory, this is your program. Somewhere in the memory, there is your data. Now we know that in the upper part of the memory, our programs or instructions are stored, and in the lower part of the memory, data is stored. Okay, so this is a processor. What do you first the address of instruction? Okay, the address is always given by the instruction. So as soon as any instruction fetch, your program counter is incremented. Okay, always address is given by the which instruction? Program counter. And as soon as any instruction fetch, your program counter is incremented. Okay, because it goes on incrementing in sequential manner. So this is how your program goes in sequential manner. Okay, so first step we need to do for fetching instruction is program counter has to put the address on address bus, and anything that is go on this address bus has to put into a MAR, that is memory address register. Okay, so your MAR is a temporary register that holds the address on the address bus. Okay, and PC put the address on the address bus, that means your program counter puts the address on the address bus. Okay, but address bus is not going to hold the address, we need somebody to hold this address. Okay, so the bus transfer currently it does not store current data, is transferred in the form of address. Okay, so if that current address has to stay on the address, somebody has to hold it. So temporary register for address bus is MAR, that is memory address register. So temporary register for data bus is MDR, that is memory data register. Okay, so program counter gives address to address bus, then MAR, that is memory address register, holds the address on the address bus, and now we are fetching instruction from memory through data bus and will into a register, and that register is called as memory data register. So anything that come from data bus is comes into the memory data register. The moment it comes in the memory data register, it will pass on into the register IR, that is instruction register. So your instruction register holds the current instruction being executed. Okay, so once the instruction comes into IR, that means the processor has acquired the instruction with this fetching is over. Okay, and one small thing remains, as instruction comes, PC has to get incremented. Once instruction is loaded into the IR, your PC has to get incremented. Okay, so PC has to become PC plus 1. Now this PC plus 1, PC plus 4 and PC plus 6 and so on is depends on the byte addressability of your memory. If your memory is 16 bit addressable, that means your PC will incremented by 4. If your memory is 32 bit byte addressability, that means your PC is incremented by 8. Okay, so that is why we always say PC gives the next instruction address. So the last step that has to happen is that PC has to become, PC has to be incremented. Okay, so this is all about the fetching up an instruction from memory into the processor. Now let's say how this fetching has done. So first of all, micro operations for fetching. So there are four steps for fetching instruction: T1, T2, T3 and T4. This T1, T2, T3 and T4, these are the clock cycles. That means clock cycle 1, clock cycle 2, 3, 4 and so on. Okay, so in the first step, contents of PC are loaded into the MAR. That means the address which is held by PC is loaded into the memory address register. Okay, so your PC will put address into MAR. Then second step, memory, that means instruction into the MDR. So instruction will come from memory into the MDR. Now PC, the contents of PC are loaded into the memory address register. Now by using this memory address register, PC will fetch the instruction from particular memory location, and after fetching this instruction by using data bus, this instruction is loaded into the processor. Okay, but before processor, this instruction first is loaded into the MDR, that is memory data register. So your memory instruction is loaded into the MDR. So instruction will come from memory into the MDR. Now in third cycle, the contents of MDR are loaded into the IR. Now the address is in the MAR. By using this MAR, we fetch instruction. Instruction is loaded into MDR. Now your MDR is holding instruction. Now we have to transfer that instruction from MDR into the IR, because IR always holds the instruction which is being executed. So now the contents, that means the instruction stored in MDR, is transferred to the IR. Now here fetching is done. Okay, now once the instruction is loaded into the IR, your PC must get incremented. So in the fourth step, your PC will be incremented. Now these four steps are common for each and every instruction, that is for fetching. Okay. Now there is a processor. It has fetch an instruction. That is, it has to do these four steps. First, PC going to do four steps simultaneously? No. It happens one by one. Should the processor take its own time to do? No. Every operation needs a trigger. So something has to go on triggering. The processor has to do an activity. Okay. So PC does not understand time. Something have to go on triggering the PC to do an activity. So that is done by the processor clock. So every clock pulse is triggered to the processor to enable a processor to a new activity. That is why during one clock pulse is called as 1T state, that means T1. So T stands for transition, because there is a transition from one state to another state. So every activity takes place on the new pulse, that means T1, T2, T3 and T4. So this stands for transition 1, transition 2, transition 3 and transition 4. That means in a one clock cycle. Okay, so each clock pulse triggers the processor to do a new micro operation. So these all activities that we are going to perform for fetching an instruction are called as micro operations. Okay, so these activity are called as micro operations. So they perform these micro operations in micro seconds. So microprocessor also get name like flip flop gate is used in microprocessor. So how much time do they take 1T state? How much is that? It depends upon your processor speed. Okay, so these are the four activities. That is, there are 4T state. No, there are actually three T states, one for T1, another for T2, and another for T3. So these two also required 1T state, that means one clock pulse, but these both activities are completely independent of each other. Okay, and are happen at different places of the processor, and that's why they takes place simultaneously, that is T1 and T2, and all other are depending on each other except PC. Okay, so you can overlap micro operations as long as they are independent of each other. So here pipelining concept comes. When we talk about pipelining, that time I will explain you how these all activities are overlap with each other. So the first two activities are performed simultaneously because they are completely independent of each other. But another activity, that is MDR to IR, is completely dependent on the previous activities. That's why T3 will execute separately. Okay, so these are the four compulsory steps for fetching, for addition, for subtraction, for multiplication. For each and every operation that we want to perform, we have to go through these four steps compulsorily for the fetching of an instruction. Now, what is the another way to fetch an instruction? First, T1, load the contents of PC into MAR, then memory instruction is loaded into MDR. Now here we have incremented PC after contents of MDR are loaded into IR. But another option is that once instruction is loaded into the MDR, we can increment our program counter. Okay, and the third step is that MDR to IR. Now third step is same as the previous. Okay, so instead of PC becomes PC plus one, in third state, it can happen in second T state also. So PC putting address in MAR. Who is maintaining the address on the address bus? MAR is maintaining the address on the address bus. Now who is free? Your PC is free. That means your program counter is free now. So while instruction is fetching into MDR, now your PC is free. So side by side we can increment PC. As I told you, the instructions that are independent of each other, we can perform these instructions simultaneously, okay, by overlapping. So while loading instruction into the MDR, now your PC is free. So side by side we can increment our PC. Okay, so we can do it in second or third step. So why not in first T state? Because PC is putting address into MIR. So we can't increment our PC first T state. Okay. And at the same time, how can you increment? So in T state, that is transferring instruction from MIR. At the same time, we can increment our program counter. So this is all about the micro operations for fetching. Now let's see micro operations for instruction. So when you write micro operations for instruction, first every instruction here to be fetched. So T1, T2, T3 is common in every micro operation, that is for fetching. So there are number of instructions like move, add, subtract, or whatever micro operations are not depending upon these operations. So micro operations are depending upon addressing modes. Okay, micro operations are not depending upon the operations that you want to perform. Micro operations are depending upon the addressing mode. Okay, now we know that addressing mode, there are immediate addressing mode, that means data is directly given in an instruction. Then register addressing mode, data is given in the form of register. Then direct addressing mode, data is given in the form of address. Then indirect addressing mode, your address is given inside the register, that is indirect addressing mode. And last one is the implied addressing mode. Okay, so your micro operations are depending upon the addressing mode. So let's see each addressing mode one by one. So first one is the immediate addressing mode. In immediate addressing mode, data should be given in the instruction itself, like move BL, 25. Okay, now first of all, instruction has to be fetched. So first load the contents of PC into MIR, then instruction is loaded into MDR, then once and the contents of MDR are loaded into IR, and after that increment the PC. These are the common steps for each and every instruction for fetching the instruction. Okay, now T4. Now execution, what has to get, what BL has to get? 25. Okay, because instruction is move BL, 25, that means we have to transfer this 25 into BL. So BL will get 25. So instruction comes through the data bus to the MDR, and from MDR to IR. Now what IR contain? Instruction. Which instruction? Move BL, 25. What is BL? BL is your general purpose register. It has to get the value 25. Now where is 25? 25 is where is 25 into IR. Okay, now only thing which have to done is move 25 from IR to BL. Okay, and that is you are executing BL will get the value 25 from IR. Okay, IR is holding BL, 25. Okay, so now we have to just transfer this 25 into BL from IR, that is instruction register. So your T4 state is transferring this 25 to the BL from instruction register IR. Now if your instruction is add BL, 25, then what will happen? 25 is added with the BL and result is stored in BL itself. Okay, so important is what is definition. What is definition? Data is given in the instruction, and that's why it is coming from IR instruction register. So this is all about your immediate addressing mode. Okay, so your micro operations are not depending upon the what type of instruction you are executing. It depends on the which type of addressing mode you are working on. Then next one is the register addressing mode. Now what is the definition of register addressing mode? Data is given by a register. Okay, so instruction is that move BL, CL. That means here we have to transfer contents of CL into the BL. Now again, T1, T2, T2 and T3. These are the fetching steps and common for all instruction. So now execution. After T3, your fetching is over. Now start executing your instruction. Now instruction is coming in IR. Now we know that the contents of MDR are loaded into IR. Now here your IR is containing move BL, CL. Okay, so BL has to get the value of CL. Now where is BL? Inside the processor, because BL is general purpose register, so BL is inside the processor. Where is CL? CL is again inside the processor because CL is also general purpose register. So for this, do you need anything extra? No. Any activity or do you require any address bus or data bus? No. Only you need to move contents of CL into BL. Okay. So your T4 will be transferring the contents of CL into BL. Now both the registers are inside the processor. That means we don't need to use memory address register because our data is not stored in memory. We don't need to use memory data register because we don't want to transfer data from memory to MDR. We can directly transfer data from one register to another register. Okay, so that means now your T4 step will be transferring the contents of CL into BL. Okay, now I think you clearly understand. So the definition of addressing mode is clearly evident for the fourth T state. Okay, so register addressing modes, that's why data coming from a register. So you can also do addition, subtraction, like add BL comma CL, subtract BL comma CL. Then next one is the direct addressing mode. So what is direct addressing mode? Address will be given in the instruction. Now move BL comma in square bracket 2000H. This square bracket indicates that this 2000 is works as an address, not as a data. Okay, so who gets what? BL gets the content of location 2000H. Okay, so here BL gets the contents of 2000H. Now again T1, T2, T3, these are the common steps for the fetching of an instruction. Now after that we have to perform execution. Okay, so instruction comes to the IR. Again in the T3 step, look here, from MDR, instruction comes into the IR. Okay, so move BL comma in square bracket 2000. So BL has to get the contents of memory location 2000. So somewhere in the memory, let's consider this is memory. Somewhere in the memory, there is a location 2000. And it contains data 77. Okay, so BL has to get that data 77. So who needs data? BL needs data. What it needs? It needs 77. That is, it has to get data from memory location 2000 because we have only address. We have only address 2000 and we have to fetch data from that memory address. That is, the value of 2000 have to be put on which bus? Address bus. So to put anything on the address bus, it have to first put on MAR, that is memory address register. So that is your four step. First, we have to put this address 2000 into the MAR. Now here, your IR is holding this instruction. So from IR, that means in IR, there is address 2000 and we have to put that 2000 address into the MAR in the four step, that is T4. So MAR will get the address from the IR instruction register. So now that address will go to the memory location 2000 and select the data 77. Okay, now that 77 will put a data from memory into the data bus and then come into the MDR, that is memory data register. Now this data 77 from memory location 2000 is loaded into the MDR, memory data register. Okay, so this is step 5. Now by using data bus, you get the data and instruction. Now if you get instruction, it will go into the IR again in the instruction register, and if you get the data, it will go into the MDR. Okay, so this data will now come into the BL. Now we get the data into the BL, that is 77 from memory location 2000. So this is all about the direct addressing mode. Then next one is the indirect addressing mode. Now what is indirect addressing mode? Address is given by a register. Now here address is directly given in the instructions. This square bracket indicates that this 2000H is a memory address. Now here address is given by a register. Now the instruction is move CL comma BX. Now BX is given inside a square bracket. That means this BX register holding memory address. Now CL will get the data from memory location pointed by register BX. Now again T1, T2, T3. These three steps are common for each and every instruction. That means these three steps are common for fetching an instruction. Now what is T3? IR will get the contents of MDR. Okay, these are the common steps for fetching an instruction. Now instruction into IR is move BL comma in square bracket BX. So CL is getting the data from memory location pointed by register BX. Now let's consider BX holding address 4000. Okay, so BX is only giving address. Since it is given giving address, that address must be put on a MAR, that is memory address register. Okay, so your fourth T state will be transferring BX to MAR. That means this address 4000 is transferred to the memory address register. Now MAR will get the address from BX. Step number 4. Now address put on address bus and data will come from the memory through the data bus into the MDR, that is memory data register. Now again in memory, somewhere there is a memory location 4000. This 4000 holding a data 77. So this is your step number 5. That means from memory location 4000, the 77 is transferred into the memory data register MDR. Okay, so once MDR gets data, it is go into the GPR. That means it is go into the CL, general purpose register. Okay, so this is all about the indirect addressing mode. Now next one is the implied addressing mode. In implied addressing mode, address is implied by the carry flags. Now STC stands for set carry flag. That means making the carry flag to 1. Now again, though it is an implied addressing mode, T1, T2, and T3, these three steps are common for fetching an instruction. So within the ALU, within the whole execution unit, there is a flag register. And within the flag register, there is a carry flag. So you have to fetch the instruction IR, which says STC, that means set the carry flag. That is make the carry flag to 1. And to make carry flag become 1, you don't need any activity. It's a simple operation, CF become 1. That means STC. If we set STC, your carry flag will become 1. So your fourth step is that CF is set to 1. Carry flag is set to 1. So you don't need memory address bus. When you need address and data bus, when you want to work on memory. So here you don't need any memory and address bus. Okay, so this is the micro operations of control unit, and these all sequences, that is T1, T2, T3, and T4, these all called as micro instruction sequencing. Okay, and the instructions that we are performing are called as instructions. The operations that we are performing on that micro instructions called as micro operations, and the sequence of executing each and every micro instruction is called as micro instruction sequencing.